Hello children, today we will be doing English prose standard 9th 4.4 My Financial Career. Welcome to Sarosh Digital Learning. We will be doing warming up by starting with the meaning of the lesson. The financial means money, career year means profession. When you open a savings account at a bank, you need to fill in a deposit form or slips. Observe the following forms and fill in your details. This page number 100 of the chapter, you will be doing filling of the form for homework. Understood? So I'll be explaining to you the lesson on the next page, page 101. Please listen to the explanation. When the author goes to the bank, he gets rattled. What is the meaning of rattled? Nervous. The clerks, the wickets rattle. The sight of money rattles him. Everything rattles him. Rattles means makes him nervous. He feels himself to be a big J. J is a person who talks foolishly, without thinking. Sometimes it happens to us also. When we are irresponsible, we just mutter something which no one can understand. That is, I become an irresponsible idiot. The author calls himself irresponsible, one who cannot handle responsibility. An idiot, again here, means a foolish person. Now, he is looking timidly at the clerks, he shambles and he is ruined like anything. He feels himself to be helpless. And he said, I want to see the manager. And he fumbles and says, I want to consult means I want to meet the manager. His voice sepulchral, that is gloomy and sorrowful. In front of the accountant, he meets the accountant of the bank, and he cannot even speak. He just trembles and says, I want to meet the manager, who takes him to the takes the writer to the manager. The manager is a grave and very fearful looking man. Followed now. But he is cool and calm. He listens to the writer. He has raised in his salary. That is why he wanted to deposit his money into the bank. Because he had a raise in his salary of about $50 a month. And he felt, the author felt, that the bank was the only place for it to be kept safe. He kept his $56 clutched, that is holding tight in his pocket. He kept his money, that is clutched in a crumpled ball. He had already crumpled his notes in his pocket and he was trembling in front of the manager. Are you the manager? He asks the manager. The manager says, God knows, I didn't doubt it. Okay. As soon as he approaches the manager, he added the word alone. Instead of saying that I have come to the bank, he tells the manager that he has come alone and he wants to speak to him alone. The manager looks at him and is alarmed, is surprised, tells him to meet him in a separate or a private room and takes him to a private room where no one will interrupt them, and tells the author that no one will interrupt them and they can be safe. The manager considers him to be a very big millionaire, belonging to a millionaire's family, that is a very rich, coming from a rich family, belonging to the Pinkerton's family. We go to page 102. And the other people in the bank think him to be a detective. He is considered to be a detective, one who asks things which are not known to him, and he is made to look very miserable, and all of them keep looking at him, all the eyes in the bank, the clerk, the accountant and the manager, all are looking at the writer, and they consider him to be Rothschild or a young one of a Gould. Gould are millionaires. They are rich people belonging to the rich cult of the English community. The writer's temperamental behavior, changeable behavior of the writer, makes the people in the bank to look at him again and again. Mr. Montgomery, he said unkindly and loud, "This gentleman is opening an account. He will deposit $56 and tells him to help the gentleman, that is the writer. But the writer looks miserable, reckless, and a short-tempered person, an idiot, a big foolish, ghastly, pale. His face also changes. He keeps on changing his face. Ghastly means horrible. Pale means worn out, sad, gloomy. All these type of facial expressions can be seen on the writer. Is it deposited? He gives the money to the accountant and he asks, is it deposited? And the hollow vibrating voice of the accountant says, yes, I have deposited your check. Instead of saying C-H-E-Q-U-E check to the accountant, he spells the word check is written wrong in the slip. C-H-E-C-K. Here check means to search. But when you go to the bank, the check, the actual spelling of the check is C-H-E-Q-U-E. The author makes a mistake. Again, he is regarded as an idiot or a foolish person. We go to page number 103. Now, what happens? The attitude of his, of this writer, makes everyone to look him to be a fearful man, a fearless, fearfully quick-tempered. He is regarded as a thoughtless man. All of them think that he is a thoughtless. They say, no, that a rich, spoiled brat. So they think him to be a millionaire, which is invalid, not considered to be a fit to be a millionaire. Millionaires are always considered to be highly educated, decent, having good manners in the society. But this author is considered to be reckless or miserably bad condition. He cannot even speak to the people whom he comes across, especially to the manager, to the accountant, to the clerks. They all keep looking at him. His idiotic behavior makes him look foolish. And his ways of writing, his education, the way of spelling check, all this makes him look quick-tempered. The clerk prepares the money, but when he goes and interrupts in the middle and tells that I want to withdraw $6 from it. And on the slip, instead of writing $6, he writes the full amount, $56, the amount which was just deposited. He puts it on the withdrawal slip that he wants to withdraw. They all keep looking at him for his foolish behavior, because just now he deposited the money and quickly he is withdrawing it. What type of a person he is considered? He is considered an invalid millionaire, a foolish idiot by the bankers. And he immediately takes the money back and runs out of the doors of the bank, swinging the doors behind him. All the people in the bank roar with laughter. They keep laughing at him, and the ceiling of the bank echoes with laughter. And the author feels very disgusted and shameful, and he walks out of the bank thinking that he will never bank anymore. He keeps his money in cash in his trousers pockets from then onwards, and his silver dollars in a socks. These are his bank places. Where are his bank places? His own trousers pockets and his socks. This lesson is written by Stephen Leacock. This is an animated film. Actually, you can get to see it on the television. You may see it and watch the movie. I will send you a video too. Thank you, children. Stay home, stay safe.